At this moment, this ground report is coming to you from Ahmedabad Civil Hospital. This is the main COVID facility of the city. Behind me is the special COVID facility where there are 1,200 beds. And in fact, in this larger complex, there are about 1,700 beds. We're here on the ground in Ahmedabad as the city goes in for a hard lockdown of a week. In fact, other than milk and medicines, even vegetable and grocery stores are going to be closed. This, as Ahmedabad accounts for the majority of cases in Gujarat and has seen a sharp number of fatalities this week. To get a sense of what's happening on the ground here at the civil hospital, let's introduce our guest. We have here senior bureaucrat Pankaj Kumar, who's of course in charge of overseeing the response of the state to this COVID pandemic and the crisis that is, and the challenges that have followed. Sir, sabse pehle, what is the overall situation? This has been a difficult week. Ahmedabad mein ek hard lockdown ho gaya hai. We have seen the highest fatality in a single day anywhere in the country taking place here. Overall situation?
We are following a very dynamic strategy. Every evening the core committee meeting meets under Honorable Chief Minister and we take a stock of the last 24 hours and accordingly we re-strategize if that is required, and we are taking all possible actions both on the surveillance part, testing part, as well as on the treatment part.
Now, sir, I know this is a red zone and we're in this space that we're allowed to stand in under the supervision of the hospital. But in this space, I'll ask you to just walk a little bit so our viewers can see what's happening. On this side, you actually see buses that are, vans that are lined up to take away patients who do recover. But sir, what do you, how are you dealing with the high mortality rate that you have seen this week?
Actually, we are trying to give the best medical treatment here. In addition to our normal medical strength, we have drawn resources from other medical colleges also. And we have also involved the best in the, which is available in the private sector. And the critical care specialists, they have started visiting our hospitals. And we are also going to get expert visit from Delhi and other places.
I believe an All India medical team is also coming of doctors.
Yes, yes. Honorable Chief Minister requested the government of India and they are also coming very soon.
So I'm just going to give our viewers again a sense, if the camera can move this side, then I'll give you a sense of what's happening here. That is the hospital. That is the 1,200 bed COVID hospital. And we're talking on the ground to Pankaj Kumar, the chief bureaucrat in charge of managing this response. Sir, let's just walk a little bit. I'll ask you again, what are the main challenges that you're facing at this point? We got a sense of the hospital. We saw that there is an area where people are being discharged. But again, given this hard lockdown, and we saw this panic buying of groceries, jaise ki hota hai logon mein, kya main challenge hai?
You know, the government is managing in all the fronts, whether it's a surveillance, it's a isolation, it's a testing, and then giving the best treatment. Simultaneously, through lockdown, we are trying to enforce social distancing and the concept of you stay at home, then you are more safe. We are also addressing the issue of the migrant laborers going back to their respective states. And from 10th, now this international NRIs, they are also coming to Ahmedabad. And so we are working on that also. So there are challenges, but then the state is totally geared to handle that. And we are getting full cooperation from all the wings of the government as well as from the public.
Sir, in certain cities, we have seen doctors and health workers targeted. They've had to face stigma. Wo ghar jaate hain, toh housing societies unko ghusne nahi deti. In some cases, there's been violence. Have you had to deal with those problems?
No, we have been very fortunate. We haven't had any such single incidents.
What about hospitals themselves being vulnerable? Agar aap dekhen dusre shaharon mein, in Mumbai, entire hospitals have had to be sealed because health workers contract the infection. How are you dealing with that? And have you had any cases here of doctors? I read that the one of the municipal commissioners had to go into quarantine. So how are you dealing with people at the front line, people like yourself, protecting yourselves taki aap hi log vulnerable na ho jaye?
Dekhiye, isme government of India ke jitne bhi guidelines hain about the infection control, we are taking all those precautions, whether it's a question of surveillance, taking samples, or all the protocol of treatment in the hospitals. Like you see this 1200 bedded hospital.
Yes.
And in this campus, there are 1700 total beds.
Yes.
And almost 1500 staff, they are working round the clock, and more than 1,000 patients are always admitted here. But till this date, we have very few number of cases where our own staff has got infected. So on one hand, infection control, we are giving a top priority, plus all the staff who are working here, we have provided them total accommodation. And
so they don't go home, they stay.
They don't go home. And even their, when their 7-day duty is over, then we extend their accommodation in case they don't wish to go back. And then we continue their accommodation. So some of them are, they are here who are in our accommodation, and that could be the best hotels in the city or the various hostels for more than a month or so.
You mentioned the migrant workers and also the returning NRIs which are going to come. So that means that Gujarat has to brace itself for a further spike in cases, are you expecting?
No, in fact, we have very clear-cut guidelines from the Government of India. And on all these fronts, we are totally adhering to that. So we are absolutely confident that these situations will not escalate. And say international travel, international Indians who are coming here. So basically, we will be keeping them into institutional quarantine. And the arrangements in the various districts are being undertaken.
Are you, for migrant workers, a lot of states are only testing for fever or phir unko aage bhej dete hain. Aapka kya faisla hai ispe? Temperature screening or actual tests?
No, we have this out migration of the this thing. In fact, we don't have many cases of in migration.
Yeah.
So all those special trains are there, and they're testing whether he is positive or not through thermal scanning or through guns. We pick them and then we allow.
Sir, any assessment of why Gujarat has seen a very high mortality rate compared to the rest of the country this week?
I will say that for us, every life is very precious. And we are trying to give our best available treatment with our inherent capacity as well as the best available in the private. So we are combining both and we are trying to address them. And it's again not very fair to compare the mortality rate of different states, because the circumstances are different, socio-economic conditions of the patients are different.
Yes.
All I can assure you that the state government along with the private sector, we are not leaving any stone unturned to save every single life which is here and who comes to the hospital.
Now, let's just step back. As we said, we're at the COVID facility in Ahmedabad at the Civil Hospital. And these are some of the top doctors here. The top doctors team is all here with me. And we've also got Jayanti Ravi, another key bureaucrat, principal secretary in the government, who's handling this response. So if I may just start with you to help us understand the high mortality rate, as Pankaj Ji was saying, that you can't compare state to state. But still, medically, what is your assessment, sir?
I think we are facing a challenge of major complications. And these complications not only restricted to the lungs, but we are also looking at a high number of patients that are developing vascular complications in terms of major vessels being occluded, including and the minor vessels being occluded. And this is a real challenge that we are facing, because like we know that, I mean, for a patient who is developing a coagulation process into the major and the minor vessels, we can give them anticoagulants, but these are the patients. They are not responding adequately to the optimal dose of the anticoagulants. And we are going for aggressive therapy for anticoagulation. But despite that, there is an ongoing process, and the reason could be the hyperinflammations produced by this coronavirus. But why our Gujarati patients, they are getting these hyperinflammations and the major vessel occlusions, still we are not finding an answer.
So you're still studying
that? Yes, yes.
If you'd like to add to that, sir.
The only thing, other thing would be comorbidities. What we have been seeing is many patients are having multiple comorbidities, number one. And probably it is long time, about a month and a half or two, people have not had an opportunity to go for follow-ups or not to go and get treatments done because of lockdown, which was a mandatory thing.
Yes.
When these patients, they come with corona or COVID, it is primary comorbidity that gets aggravated. And we have seen even in the mortality trend that the patients who come and lose their life within 24 hours, it is their primary comorbidity which is creating an issue. So the studies are going on, the research is awaited, probably we will be able to come up with some good outcome on these patients as well.
Are you seeing any specifics that you can say in terms of age? Because we've also seen positive stories of elderly people recovering on the other hand.
Yes, so elderly people also recovering, but majority comorbidity are usually with more than 50 years of age. The patients who are elderly, must have hypertension, diabetes, and Gujarati love of food, so diabetes is the highly prevalent. So this is one of the risk factors for the comorbidity and the higher complication rate in the Gujarati population.
So diabetes is, of course, a major comorbidity. Sir, any understanding of the kind of patients you've seen so far, any larger pattern you can draw?
One of the most common cause of the increased mortality in Gujarat they are in a late arrival of the symptoms to the patient. Mm. One of the latest arrival. Majority of the death, 30% death occur within 24 hours of the arrival in admission to the hospital, and 56% occur within 48 hours. So there is no chance available to treat, and there are out of 100 patients, 62% who died are having more than double comorbidity.
So comorbidities and asymptomatic in the beginning. So sir, you made this important point about people being asymptomatic, and in fact we're seeing this in other parts of India also.
Asymptomatic is one of the carrier for other patients. In the process of asymptomatic, if the old people, comorbid, come across and they get infected, then they will be have a mortality, and other young people will not. So take the example of temperature. Suppose you got 100 temperature, very mild temperature, does not mean that he has no serious disease. Even with a mild temperature, it is a response to the body.
So it could be virulent even with seemingly low symptoms. If you were wanting to explain.
Yeah, this the young deaths which is happening, you can say they are the super stormers or the quick stormers, early stormers.
Yes.
The one who has a very high immune system function, he would react in over and above the required way, that is overwhelming way. So that leads to high cascade of inflammation, and that leads to thrombosis, that leads to sometimes loss of life. Those who are elderly, those who have a slower immune system, they prolong the presentation, but by that time it has gone to that severity that before it comes up on the surface, the other comorbidities would become severe, and that kills them.
So basically it means that if you don't have symptoms or you're very mild, you should not take it for granted. What about the heat? Do we have any science on the heat? Because it's really, really hot here in Ahmedabad.
Ji.
Ji, bataye. Heat se koi relation?
Either you go to Himalaya or you go to Idar, highest temperature in the Gujarat. The body temperature within remain 37 degree. So virus inside remain or that 37 degree. But once someone comes out sneezing or coughing, in that case is the virus come out with secretions. It is only a host, environmental agent. Agent is same. Host is now it's out of the host. But environment temperature is more. So in hot atmosphere, the survival of the virus within the secretions outside the body is less. And that's why there is always some degree of hope that temperature will reduce the transmission of the virus from person to person, that is sure. Gujarat, being a capital of one of the capital of diabetes,
yes,
and other comorbid conditions, that's why we see more common death in comorbidities, elderly population is more, and young people who are dying, there is some, there are two people,
yes,
two variety of people. One where he is on some immunosuppressive therapy, some steroids because of some SLE, rheumatoid arthritis, some diseases, they are on immunosuppressive therapy. Or the pure group where he does not have any disease and still they die, and that's the role of a viral load. The doctor mentioned about the cytokine storm. On in any infection, on fourth or fifth day, generally the body says, now no more, break. But when that break becomes accelerator, more than 150 cytokines release at a time, and within 24 hours, 36 hours, 6 hours, patient becomes breathless, he cannot complete a single sentence, and then they die.
So this is a very important, reality check, as it were. We're getting on the medical complexities. There is some science also being done on whether different strains are being seen in different parts of India.
So this is again a conjecture or a hypothesis, but we've had some of our doctors, experts saying that this could perhaps be, there are two strains, the L strain and the S strain. The S strain is the more simpler version, the less virulent version, while the L strain is the more virulent version. So there is a school of thought which says that the manifestation of this virus here is of the more virulent kind, the L kind. But this needs some more research to actually pull out the sequencing and actually figure out which one it is. And there are scientists trying to do that. But nevertheless, we are not leaving any stone unturned. We're doing everything possible from the government to, in terms of protocols that are being followed, in terms of trying out new medicines, telementoring, which we do every day religiously. Our experts interact with critical patients. And we're also we're also part of the WHO solidarity trials.
Yeah.
So we're doing newer interventions to see if anything can be done to improve the mortality rates.
So I just want to ask all of you in the end, because please do add to it, but I also want to ask you, you're all frontline warriors, you know, the doctors we're seeing here, there is of course Pankaj Kumar and Jayanti Ravi, who are the bureaucrats at the front line, but you all are the heroes. You're exposing yourself every day, you're taking risks every day. How do you keep yourself safe, and how do you keep yourselves positive?
Yeah, just, I mean, follow the simple principles that, I mean, you need to protect yourself. So follow all the measures that you need to take when you are entering into the COVID ward. I mean, that's a very, very easy and simple answer. But let me, I mean, add more value to this, that the infection generally acquired through the oral cavity from the nose and the, from the conjunctiva, so the face. So you need to protect your face. Do not touch your face unnecessarily. Take care of your hands very vigilantly. So if you are taking care of your hand and if you are covering your mouth and the nose with the proper mask, especially when you are entering, if you are wearing a N95 mask, I think this is the minimum sufficient measures which can protect you. So I mean, I think I can say that if the healthcare workers are taking care of their hand and the face, that is sufficient.
You want to add to that, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah.
One thing is complete and perfect use of the PPE, yes. Personal protective equipments. And while wearing, doctor is clean, healthcare worker is clean, and PPE also clean. But when we remove it, utmost care to be taken that we don't infect ourselves, number one. Second thing is adequate hydration.
Yes.
Third thing is a heavy breakfast. Some light sort of exercise, pranayama or some Surya Namaskar or something.
Yes.
10 to 12 per day. And to remain cheerful. Chidananda Rupa Shivaham Shivaham. That makes immunity, it purifies immunity. And that also adds to the value.
And that's why I'm smiling, because I think I'm so happy. I'm so happy to hear someone talking about the emotional dimension to this, because there's been so much fear, so much paranoia, so much hysteria. I'll just give Pankaji the last word as we close here. One challenge that keeps you awake at night. रात को जब नींद नहीं आती, वो क्या सोच रहे होते हैं आप?
To save each and every life.
Well, we thank you all for your service, Pankaj, Jayanti, and especially I want to leave this the image of these wonderful doctors. A big salute to them here at the COVID facility in Ahmedabad, one of the virus hotspots of the country.